We're back at Culture Wars Radio. I'm David Wemhoff. We're talking to Dr. E. Michael Jones, the publisher and editor of Culture Wars Magazine, a monthly commentary and news magazine that will wake you up from your stupor that's induced by the drive-by mainstream media. You're going to find out what's really going on in the world and in the culture wars. Now, we're talking today to Dr. Jones about Don't Ask, Don't Tell. There was, over the weekend, a bill was passed in the Senate. It's now going to the president, which repeals the policy of Don't Ask, Don't Tell in the military, and now homosexuals can serve openly in the military. Dr. Jones has said that this bill is, the effect of it is to equalize queer or homosexual marriage with normal marriage between two heterosexuals, and it also means that you shouldn't ask for a raise. I'm curious about, we've been talking about the natural law, how do we get to the don't ask for a raise?
All right. If there's no nature, then there's no natural law.
Okay.
If there's no natural law, there's no morality.
Okay.
If there's no morality, there's no such thing as right and wrong.
Okay.
Okay? If there's no such thing as right and wrong, you can do whatever you want. Right?
It would seem that way, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's great, isn't it?
Well, sure. That's freedom, isn't it?
That's freedom, right? So what's wrong with that?
Nothing. That's what 200 and some years of American history is.
That's what America's all about, doing what you want.
That's right.
Okay. Now, let's assume that two people want the same thing. Who's
going
to get it? Who's going to get the same thing in this world where there's no nature, no natural law, no right and wrong, no morality?
Well,
two people want the same thing. That's absolutely right. The stronger is going to get it.
Or they're going to make a deal.
And so what you're saying here is if you can do whatever you want, the strong are going to be the people who get everything, everything they want. The strong will rule, and force is going to be the only rule of action.
Well, isn't this repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell a sign of the weak actually winning in this system? I mean, there's such a minority.
No, absolutely not.
The homosexuals are a minority.
Absolutely. They are a minority. They are a tiny minority.
So this is power here. This is great that they won.
No, this only means that the powerful forces are backing this little tiny minority as the avant-garde of revolution in the United States. That's what it means. The revolution always needs an avant-garde for 90 years. No, I'm sorry. For 60 years, let's say 1909 to 1969, there was another avant-garde of the revolution, or at least they tried to make it that way. It was the black people of the United States. And the people, what I'm talking about here is something called the Black Jewish Alliance, which began with the forming of the NAACP in 1909. For 60 years, the people who ran the NAACP, namely the Jews, tried to turn the black people of this country into the avant-garde of revolution. The civil rights movement was a manifestation of that. In 1967, this whole thing fell apart. The Black Jewish Alliance fell apart. A man by the name of Harold Cruz wrote a book called The Mind of the Catholic, The Mind of the Crisis of the American Negro. Anyway, that's probably not the title, but I could get the title. But anyway, what happened is that the Black Jewish Alliance fell apart. And so we needed a new avant-garde, and that's where the homosexual became. 1969, the Stonewall Riots, the homosexuals then become the heirs of the civil rights movement, and they become the avant-garde of the revolution. So what we're seeing here is that a tiny minority that has no significance whatsoever demographically has now been made the heir of the civil rights movement, which means that they have become a special class, and they can use this, the powers that be can use this tiny minority to break down the last remnant of the moral law, which is the protection of the overwhelming majority of people, the only protection the overwhelming majority of people have in this country. 1% of the population owns 95% of the wealth. That means 95% of the population is basically defenseless against these powerful people.
Wow.
And today, as a result of the passing of the revocation of this, that 95% of the population is more vulnerable than they were a week ago because they have no defense against force And the main expression of force in this country is money.
That's pretty powerful. What you're saying is that the homosexuals have been used to basically weaken everybody, expose them to the rich and powerful.
They have been a tool of social revolution. They are the avant-garde of social revolution. And with this action, the rule of force has become one. It's ratcheted up one more degree. It's become that more powerful. If you're talking about the Middle Ages or if you're talking about cavemen, physical strength was force. In a country like ours, in a capitalist country, money is force, and force is money. That's what we're talking about here.
And so revolution in America has always been then a way to tear down the moral order, to let the powerful rule while the weak think actually, you know, it's good for them.
Right. In other words, you're told the way it goes is, okay, kids, there's no right and wrong. You can act on all your impulses. And we say, great, I'm free to do whatever I want. Okay?
That's right.
And so you go out and you act on your sexual desires, and all of a sudden you realize when you want to appeal to some type of adjudicator, if there's a conflict, you just kicked away the moral order. You destroyed it. That's the only thing that you can appeal to if you're not one of the 1% of the plutocrats that rule this country. You kicked it away because you wanted what you wanted.
So
okay?
You're not going to be heard in this society unless you're rich and powerful.
Well, they're going to say, well, what's this moral law? You just broke the moral law. You agreed to go along with sexual liberation. You got what you want. You got your birth control pills. You got your pornography. So just be happy with that, because that's all you're going to get now, buddy. So don't ask for a raise. Don't ask for a raise. You have birth control pills. You have pornography. And you can say, well, wait a minute, this isn't just. And you say, well, if you're one of the plutocrats that rules the world, you say, well, what's justice? What do you mean justice?
Right. Right.
There's no justice in this world. There's only force. And the proof of this is what you just did. Here we're rewarding people who do violence against nature. If you're saying there's no difference between sodomy and marriage, you're saying there's no nature, there's no morality. If there's no morality, you have no appeal. You have no court of appeal here. When they're grinding you into dust, you know, when they're lowering your wages, what are you going to say? I need to support a family? Just wait for the burst of laughter that follows that. Ha, ha, ha. Who said you had a right to have a family? You have a right to be sexually liberated, not to have a family.
Well, we've always been told that America is based on right over might, and there are certain principles above men. And
well, wait, John, our great thinker, Tom Paine.
Yeah.
Common sense. In America, the law is king. In America, the law is king. Well, you're a lawyer. What's this law based on?
Well, to be law, St. Thomas Aquinas said it has to be based on the moral order.
If there's no moral order, there's no law. I don't care. All you have to do is think about that, and you know it's true, no matter who said it. And you just kicked over. You said not only is there no moral law, you said there's no such thing as nature. That means two homosexuals in a men's room somewhere, that's the same thing as your grandmother and grandfather getting married and having children that begat your father and your mother and then you begetting. It's all the same thing.
Well, the repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell is certainly a dramatic moment in the history of America, which has a long history of revolution to tear down the moral order. But it didn't all start with America. And when we come back from the break, we're going to find out the principles, where they were forged, the basic principles that inform this society known as America and has led to things as Don't Ask, Don't Tell. You're listening to Culture Wars Radio. You can find out more about Culture Wars Magazine, a monthly news and commentary magazine with incisive, biting insights into what is going on in the world, by going to www.culturewars.com.